Hey there, we're working on this challenge. It says to write a function name depends on the type that takes in a single parameter object, which is short for object. That's enough information for me to get started. So let's go ahead and just knock out this function header while we're at it. All right, we've done what it's asked us to so far. It says this function is going to work on the data types, Boolean, string, float, and integer. And what is returned depends on the data type. It says if the object is an integer, so let's just go ahead and say if my type of object is an integer, then we're going to, and we have some nested conditions in here. The function will return zero if object is equal to zero. So let's say if obj is equal to zero, return the string zero. So that's our first sub-condition. Then we'll naturally want to go to our next condition. If the function will return the square of the integer, if it is even. So elif object modulo 2 is 0, right? If it's evenly divisible by 0, then we're going to run a return object squared. And then for the last condition, it tells us the function will return the cube of the integer if it's odd. So that's our only remaining case. So we can just go else and we'll return the cube. Now for our next one, again, we're going to go with the elif statement. Our next condition is type of object is equal to float. If this is the case, we want to return that object multiplied by 1.5. Right, so that's just a single return obj times 1.5. Then we've got another elif. I know that I'm going to be doing a type check again. So we can go ahead and say the next one that we're going to look for is string. That's the order of our directions. Elif type of obj is equal to string. Then what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to return that obj concatenated with itself. So I can do obj times 2. I could also do obj plus obj, but to keep things Pythonic, I'll say obj times 2. That's concatenated with itself. And then we have one more condition. Elif type obj is equal to a Boolean. Then what we're going to do is return the negation of that Boolean. So to negate in Python, we just use the not keyword. So we'll just return not object. And then we are given this last condition. If the object is not one of the above data types, return none. So lastly, I will go ahead and simply return none if none of my previous conditions are met. I can go ahead and run this and see if that works. And I do get a correct test.